me and Liam really felt like going on a walk, so we thought we'd make a video out of it. Today, we're going up what the locals call the mountain. It's really more of a hill, and we thought we'd give you a look of where we really like to go on walks. Okay, we'll show you more later.
Here in the middle of the woods, some exercise equipment.
So here's Leon working out on the free exercise equipment. Head on over to the next station, honey. This is just in the woods. We're in the wilderness.
Oh, this one has to lift my own weight, so it's actually hard.
Yeah. So there's Leon working out. It's free. It's just in the middle of the woods. People can walk by seeing you.
This is
Leon's favorite. He calls it the hump machine.
It's good. Oh, works your hip flexors. Really good. And your thigh.
And then there's the back massaging one.
Almost entirely sure. This is just to massage your back. You don't know what I'm doing.
Okay, so that's a look. At some weight equipment. Why are there sandbags? Why? The question will be answered up the path. Okay, so these are trenches and they're maintained for practice.
These ones aren't, but there's some further up the mountain that are.
Yeah, and
these
then here's more exercise equipment and former training stuff for the military. Can I walk over here? You can see other people working out.
But he's got a net to catch dragonflies.
If we walk down here, you can actually see more of the trenches. And that's what those sandbags were earlier. So you can see the trenches. Right next to the exercise equipment. Very, very cool. Hold on, there's one more thing.
Oh, yeah.
Look right here.
Look in the front of it. You see the
bunker
front.
Thing. So look to the front. There you go. Very, very interesting. Again, right next to the exercise equipment. So there's more of the path. And as Leon keeps walking forward, up ahead, there's mounds of grass. It was the first grass we ever saw in Korea. First time we went on this path. And here they are right here. And we had no clue what they were. We didn't know if they were remnants from the war. We had no clue. Turns out, after asking some of our Korean friends, these are actually old, old tombs. They're old graves.
Several hundred-year-old tombs.
Several hundred-year-old tombs. And as we're walking, there's just a bunch of them. So it turns out we're walking through an old graveyard right now. If you remember, just up the path a ways, there was workout equipment and war stuff. Now, there is
ancient graveyards.
It's a very interesting walk, isn't it, Leon?
Quite right.
We'll show you some more as we head up.
Okay, so right now, I'm still on the trail. Let's walk over here. Oh, I'm off the trail. Oh no. What am I doing? And then you look out here. Oh my goodness. Those are rice paddies.
So we were walking, and we decided to watch this older woman. She was digging through the ground for something, so we were curious what she was digging for. And she saw us, and she brought us over these. And what they do is they steam these, and then you break them open and eat them, and they're really, really good. So people are just walking along, hiking on a forest, and picking up little acorn things.
Yeah, I don't know.
Pretty excited about it.
Okay, bye. Go.
So here we have another way you could enter the path from town. And this gives new meaning to the phrase uphill both ways. That's one way, and the other way. And off in the distance, you have hills with people working on the rice fields. Okay, we're going to keep going up the path.
Do you hear that buzzing? That buzzing are the cicadas. They're really loud here. That's cool, you know. What if?
Okay, so here we are, pretty much at the end of the trail. And that was a look at a place that we like to go on a walk. Right now, I'm going to sit back and relax together on a traditional Korean platform. Okay, hope you guys enjoy the video.